Hello. Today I'll be walking you through how to use our new R package. This new R package replaces the existing R plugin that you might already have installed. The new package allows you to interface easily with Domo. The primary thing that it's used for is to get data and push data to Domo, but this new package also allows you to perform several administration tasks. So I'm going to walk through a couple of just simple examples of how to use the package, and then we will refer you to the GitHub page for any additional functionality. Okay, the first thing that we're going to do is that we need to authenticate against Domo. So we're going to do that by calling the initialization function here. So we've referenced this new package, which is called rdomo, and then we've specified the Domo function, which initializes this object. So we're going to assign it to this object called Domo. You can see that we're sending it the client ID and secret. These are credentials that you can get by going to developer.domo.com. The first thing that we will do is to download a data set from Domo. So to do this, you can see that we reference this Domo object, and then we're going to call the dsget function and send it a data set ID. So you can see now down in the console that we've successfully downloaded this data set called car data. You can also see over here in the environment that we now have this new data set called car data. So the next thing that we want to do is to push data into Domo. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run this simple aggregation. And then down here on line 22, I'm going to call the dscreate function. And this is going to create a new data set in Domo. You can see on this car summary, which I just created, I'm going to tell the name of the data set, and also I can give it a description as well. When this finishes, it's going to save the data set ID of the data set we created into this variable called car underscore DS. You can see up here in the global environment that, you know, this is the data set ID. The other thing we can do is that we can go over to Domo. And when we go to Domo, we can see here's this new data set that we've created. We can browse into the data set. And so now this data set exists in Domo just like any other data set that you have there already. The next thing that we might want to do is we might want to update that data set. In this case, what I'll show is that you can update the data set and modify the schema very easily. So I'm going to run this additional aggregation, which is just going to add the max price to the data set that we've already created. And then I'm going to call the dsupdate function. I'm going to give it the data set ID, which again we got from here on line 22. And then I'm going to send it this new data set that I've created. Great. Once that's finished, you'll notice that we get a warning that the schema has changed. And in this case, we expect the schema to change. So we're okay with that. If we go back over to Domo, you can see now in Domo that we have the max price column in this data set. All right, so we've shown that we can get data from Domo, we can create a new data set in Domo, and we can also update existing data sets. And just a note that we can update data sets that have already been created by the API. The next thing that we'll walk through is how to create PDP policies on a data set. So here you'll notice on line 33 that we can run this function that's going to retrieve all of the PDP policies that exist on this new data set we created. As you can see down in the console, we only have the one all rows policy that's there by default. So what we're going to do is construct a list object with all of the options needed to create a policy. So you can see here that we've given it the type of user, which is standard. The name is the Honda US East. You can see that we've set up a filter here to look in the make column for the value Honda. And then we've specified that we want this group to have access to that policy. So here I'll create that policy. And then I'm going to call the PDP create function. I'm going to give it the dataset ID of the dataset where I want the policy to exist, and then send it the policy definition. So that happens relatively quickly, and then we'll call this function to notice that after the policy is created, Domo is actually going to return the entire policy with the ID of that policy. So the next thing we can do is to go to Domo and see what happened over there. Now that we're in Domo, we can go to the PDP tab and notice that we now have this Honda US East PDP policy on the data set. Okay, now that we are finished working with the PDP policies, we're just going to highlight the fact that we can interface with groups within Domo as well. So down here, you notice that we're calling the groups list and the users list functions. So if I run those, then you can see that the all groups variable is going to list out all of the groups that exist in Domo, and then all users is going to list out all of the users within Domo. So the next thing I can do is use the groups list users function. You can see that if I look at this specific group, it only has the one user in it. So let's say that I want to add two users to that group, then I can call the groups add users function. And then again, after I've done that, I can call the groups list users function again, and you'll notice that I've added these two users to the package. Okay, with that, we've shown a couple of high-level details on how to use this R package. We'll refer you back to Domo and also to our GitHub page for additional details. Thank you.